Yo guys, welcome back to your brand new PDCJ with Darkest Place video. Today guys, we're going to be taking a look at a Snorlax VMAX Powerful Energy Welder deck. I haven't looked at Snorlax Welder before, but now we're going to be doing it and we are going to be pairing it with Powerful Energy, which does let Snorlax do more damage, which is pretty good. Snorlax capped at what, 210 damage, so with Powerful Energy you're doing 230, which just so happens to one-shot Zacian V's, which is pretty cool. And of course you're getting close to one-shot in like Pika. We do have Zigzagoons in here for damage, and we also play like a lot of basics just so that we can do more damage with G-Max Fall. That's why I am playing like all these different basic Pokemon, because we need Pokemon in play for Snorlax, but we can do more damage with Powerful Energy. We can put multiple Powerful Energies on it over time, making ourselves do a lot more damage and make it pretty good. Snorlax does also have buff padding, so we can give it 390 HP, make it a very bulky boy. We have double in the deck for synergy too. It's a pretty cool archetype, and it kind of just seems naturally synergistic to play Powerful Energy with Snorlax VMAX. So before we get the video, guys, of course, shout out to our sponsor, Cargaven TCG. As always, guys, if you're ever looking for any PDCGO pack codes, make sure to come over at Cargaven TCG. If you're looking for Darkest of Blaze packs, still get them over there. They are selling Darkest of Blaze codes for the cheapest right now on the market. And of course, guys, if you also want to get some of the other new products like the Eternatus VMAX box that came out, if the codes are in stock at Cargaven, if people haven't gotten them already, you can get them over there. There's some other new stuff that came out too, I'm pretty sure. So if you get any codes from Cargaven TCG, guys, make sure you use code LDF at the checkout for a 5% discount on your purchase. It greatly supports the channel, helps yourself out, supports Cargaven. So shout out to Cargaven, check them out and use code LDF. You can also check out their buy list too if you have any codes or cards you want to get rid of. You can give them to Cargaven TCG and they will give you some cash and extra credit. You can also check out my Patreon down below too, guys. If you want to pledge $2 a month for exclusive content to support the channel and all that good stuff, check out my Patreon. Also, guys, over on my Twitter, I am running a giveaway right now that will be ending on Friday. But my giveaway is going to be 5 different winners. You just have to retweet, like, and then follow me on Twitter to be entered into the giveaway. So yeah, 5 winners. Make sure to check it out. All right, let's take a look at the list. So, Snorlax VMAX with Powerful Energy. Very cool combo. There's actually a lot of new combos with Powerful Energy. This is a really good card. I can't wait to look at more Pokemon. There is a ton of decks I have in mind with Powerful Energy, because there's actually a lot of colorless Pokemon to play right now. And Snorlax is one of them. So yeah, we do more damage for each Pokemon in play. So we are just going to play a lot of basics. Goon to do more damage. Giratina, we already have Scoob Net. Might as well play it, slow the opponent down. And then of course we can also use Volcanion to build ourselves up. We got the Eldegoss to Genetic Crobat. We got a double in the deck here. It's another Pokemon that can utilize Welder and Powerful Energy. And ideally, if they knock out a Snorlax VMAX, like a Heatran or something, or like Snorlax Vulk, we can do more damage with Revenge Blast. That's it for the Pokemon. Going to the items now, we got 2 Fire Crystals, 4 Calm, 4 Quick Balls, 1 Reset Stamp. I mean, ideally, if your opponent goes through a Snorlax and a double, you stamp to 1. And then we got 4 Scoop Up Net, just use it with Zigzagoon and stuff. We got 2 Switch. I could play Jirachi in here, but I don't know what I would take out, because there's nothing really I want to remove. I want to keep the Goons, I want to keep the Vulk. The Goons can help you reach numbers you might meet, so that's why I'm still keeping the Goons in the deck. And you could put Jirachi in here, but then you probably want to play more Switch, so it clunks things up a little bit. We got 3 Giant Hearth, of course, for Welder. 2 Boss, 1 Research for Welder. No Malalana in here. You could probably fit in a Malalana if you can find room. I genuinely do not know what to take out, though. We got 2 buff padding for Snorlax, 4 Powerful Energy, and 8 Basic Fires. That's about it for the list. Pretty straightforward deck. I think it's a lot of fun. Definitely could be cool. I don't think it's like insanely good, but Snorlax and Powerful Energy is a combo that is something we gotta consider nowadays, so let's try it out. Okay guys, getting into our first match here. We're up against Bandito with a fire deck. Okay, this probably is gonna be a little bit of a fiery mirror match. We'll see how it goes. Could be a Scent Scorch. If it's actually Charizard VMAX, I don't mind that, because we have a lot of HP with buff padding, so I don't even think we really have to worry about that. Our hand is... it's okay. We can calm for Vulk, but we don't have a Switch. We could bump the Switch count up too if you want. Go 3 Switch, even 4 Switch. We also have Scoob Net. We have a few good Scoob Net starters, so I don't really know. It is a Charizard VMAX deck. Or going first. That means we could do a turn to attack with Snorlax, which is actually fine. I honestly might hold the hand. Yeah, I'm gonna hold the hand. We have a pretty good hand. All we need is an energy for next turn, and we can start attacking with Snorlax VMAX here. That's pretty good. I mean, they get the early energy attachment in, which is unfortunate, but again, as long as we find buff padding, I don't think they play Tool Scrapper. We don't have to worry about Charizard VMAX one-shotting us. We'll see how this goes. Well, that's gonna help, and Giant Hearth gives us a huge advantage. All right, cool. Yeah, I think we can beat this. As long as Charizard VMAX can't one-shot me, we should be fine. We'll see how it goes. They do already get rid of a net. We'll see how many goons and damage modifiers they already play. Looks like they're already going to get the VMAX ready to go. They got 2 energy for it. Maybe they don't have energy for the Volk, too? No, they do. Rip. I was gonna say. So this thing's already gonna be powered up, which that's a little scary. They already got the Charizard VMAX powered up. That's fine, though. I mean, we can knock out Volk, knock out Charizard, knock out Dedenne slash Crobat slash Eldegoss. That's how we can win the game. Snorlax can take out those bench sitters pretty easily, which is good. And before Snorlax, ADP is the way to go. Who knows? Who knows? Well, on the topic of ADP, they actually just announced there's a Zacian V ADP deck box coming out, which is kind of stupid. I mean, obviously they had that in mind way before the whole ban ADP train ended up even starting. So I guess it's like they weren't going to like re-out the product because people are complaining now while it was already printed. Yeah, there's a Dedenne. Star Ring Edition. Volk, Dedenne, Charizard VMAX. Pretty easy. See, I don't know. I mean, it sucks we had to get that new box because it's like now ADP is going to be even more easier to make, which makes it easier and more popular, which is a little annoying. I'm actually surprised they put on the active. Oh, there's a Goon. Wait, hold on. We can do a lot here. We can calm. I'm going to get Snorlax VMAX right away. Just want to make sure I have that big boy in play. And Hearth here. We don't need that many Pokemon to knock out the Volk, so we'll see how it goes. Quick ball away the boss. Probably get a, get a Goon. Could go Crobat too, but I'm just going to do a little Goon here. I would have liked to have done boss there, but we couldn't really get that going. Okay, we get another Goon. We're going to run out of boss, which is actually not good. That's not good. That means I might make it harder to win. We have to use Eldegoss then. Okay, I think we got the knockout, but it's a little close for comfort. Oh, we didn't have the bench, the Heat Ran. Well, I'm going to bench anyways, just as a backup attacker. Alright, Quick Ball, perfect, we get another Dedenne, or Snorlax, depending on how it goes. So we literally have to use Eldegoss for a boss if we're going to win this, unless we can somehow go through Zard. There's actually a good chance they do knock me out here, too. We didn't get the buff padding on, so they could knock me out here, which is kind of an issue. Yeah, if we get knocked out here, we are going to be in some trouble. But we do have maybe a Reset Stamp late game comeback idea. If we have to go Heatran next turn, maybe we can like do something with like Reset Stamp. Well, they are down 2 nets. There's probably, there's a chance they don't knock me out. We need to get buff padding, though, so that they can't knock me out with Zigzagoon on their turn before they use their next attack. That could be an issue. It's definitely going to be an interesting scenario. Oh, they might get another Zigzagoon. Oh, they have 2 nets here. They can knock me out, which is not good. We get knocked out here, we're definitely going to be in a bit of trouble. Though we have the option to attack with Heatran and then stamp to one if it's in the deck. That could be something we could try to pull off. Yeah, hopefully, if they have a net and a Vitality Band in their hand, I don't know. I feel like they won't. They're down 2 nets. They could have a Crobat, though. That's a little scary. Come on, don't have... No, they have a Crobat! Ugh! They might actually get a knockout here. Bro, no. The VMAX War. Personally, I think VMAXs are cooler than tag teams. Actually, this is kind of cool. Two Gen 1 Pokemon battling it out. Two of the best looking Gigantamax, VMAX, Pokemon, whatever you want to call them. Two of the best looking ones, too, battling it out. That's pretty sick. Okay, they don't have the knockout. All right. Whew, that was close. I actually thought they had it there, too, with that Crobat. Okay, well, that's not a good top deck. So we can't one-hit KO them in return. Might as well just stock damage on this in the event my opponent heals it or something. We have to... We're out of Dedenne. Alright, we're going to have to do Crobat. Give her this. Could go Heatran here. We can Steaming Stomp them and then hit them with another G-Max Fall. But there is a chance they have a boss and a triple in their hand, and I don't really like that. We could just hot burn them here, too, for 100 and 200 damage. I don't mind that. I actually don't mind that. Yeah, let's do it. Let's go for hot burn. This way, we don't give up 2 prizes right away, either. Plus, we need to find buff padding so we don't get killed by Goon. Bro... What is this hand? What? Oh my gosh. Where are my welders? I've had some bra moments before, but this is a bro moment times 50. We have the buff paddings in the deck too. Man, that's unfortunate. I don't even know what I want here. I guess we take double. Yeah, we're just gonna do the hot burn now. Hopefully they don't heal. Worst case scenario, they knock out Snorlax and my active, and we might be in trouble. Though we can still attack with double. We have Reset Stamp in the deck too, so we'll see what happens. That was a really bad Crobat though. That was a bad Crobat. Well, and we can't do Eldegoss for boss either, because it looks like we might have to get Welder here unless we get really lucky. Okay, no boss for my opponent is good. Okay, this helps. Alright, this is good. If they actually don't get a Charizard down too, we'll be in a pretty good spot. Because Snorlax can still attack. Well, I don't know if I want to go Snorlax or... I might have to just go double, to be honest. It's not safe to go Snorlax, because then we get knocked out. We need to get a buff pad on this thing so that we can't get knocked out by Goon. They could have a Goon knockout here. They've only played two Scoop Up Net. If my Snorlax gets KO'd, we're in trouble. If the Dede chains their entire hand away, I like to see it. They lose three research. That's a lot of research to play. They also lose a stamp. That's good. They've definitely got us. There's no way they won't get a Scoop Net off this, right? There's no way they don't have a Scoop Up Net here. Do they even have an energy to attack me? They've played eight fires so far. They might not have got. They might whiff an energy here too. There is a chance. This is an interesting game. This is really interesting. Oh no, they might get the triple knockout or the double knockout. There's no way. Uh-oh. Put the Charizard back. What are they getting? Volk? Uh-oh. Do they have the double Goon? Well, they have to bench a Charizard or a Volk. They need a backup attacker when we knock this thing out. Uh-oh. Man, they go down to one prize. There's like nothing we can do. They haven't even played a boss yet. So they could just boss up Zigzagoon. Unless we scoop up net it. We have two left. Oh man, this is gonna be a close game, bro. This is a close game. It sucks that Crobat had to give us such a bad hand though. It's like, bruh. Well, if they do another scoop net, they can knock me up, but then they have no bench room for another Charizard. Okay, let's see what they do here. Switch? Ooh. Okay, we draw a scoop net. No. Never mind. Don't know why I asked. If we got a scoop net here, we could have just knocked out Charizard. If only we played Cramorant. Do this, I guess. Not much else I can really do. We have stamp in the deck, so if they do take that double prize, we have that option available. And this is actually fine. We knock this out, and then we just knock out Zard, and we just gotta do one more knockout. That's not helping. If only we didn't get a bad hand off Crobat, we'd be in a way better position right now. Really need to knock this thing out. Now my opponent can most definitely take a double prize KO here. They have a two-card hand. They have another scoop-up net. They have played all their supporters, though, which is actually really good. Maybe they are just out of energy. Maybe we could just win by bossing up Dedenne or Crobat. They might actually be out of ways to remove the Charizard or anything on the bench. Well, they still have Fire Crystal, I guess. They haven't played one yet. The fact that they are also out of Welder is making me very... Maybe we can win this. Maybe we actually... If we do stamp to one, I think that seals the deal. Maybe I just attack with Eldegoss, get it back, then that gives me the option to boss again down the road. They actually bring in Crobat. Yeah, they must be out of stuff here. We might actually have them in a bit of a pickle. If we can draw into a Welder here, we can Welder to the double V. Alright, let's see if they have any energy left. I'm assuming they don't. So why would they bring in the Crobat if they did? They're probably just checking their deck. They played eight fires. They might prize one too. They haven't taken a prize yet. There's a good chance there's an energy prize. They have to not have anything. There's no way they would have not brought in Crobat. I mean, if we do get... if we can draw into a Welder here, that would be great. So we can just Welder to this, knock this out, try to get a buff padding maybe too. Seal the deal a little bit. If we knock out the Crobat, we win the game. There's so many cards we can draw here that can help us. It's insanity. Maybe we can deck them with a Reset Stamp, but they don't take a prize anytime soon. Okay, nice. Another dead card, bruh. Well, just keep building up double, I guess. Not much I can do. Now, at the very least, though, we can knock out the Crobat out. Can they move it? Do they have a switch? They've played one switch. Two switch. Two switches. It was a very interesting match. Oh, there's the boss. Okay. All right. Okay, I'm fine with this. Trap my Crobat. We have Crystal. All good. Dude, these dead draws are killing me. These dead draws. Oh, shoot. That was close. I almost moved that by accident. We should maybe hearth away the Volk. Yeah, we should have. Whatever. Okay, another energy's good. None of those prizes are really helpful right now. None of those prizes, well, other than the energy, but even then, we don't need it. I think we've won this, though. It doesn't look like my opponent has any way to win. Plus, by the time they do knock something out, we bench Eldegoss, boss up the Dene. So, yeah, it looks like we've won the game, guys. Somehow, some way. My opponent just kind of ran out of steam here at the end, it looks like. And they just couldn't bypass the Heatran. We did get lucky, though. They somehow haven't knocked out the Snorlax yet with those Zigzagoon pings. So that's pretty cool. Let's see what they do. Like, they might just not be able to knock me out. They're out of energy. I don't know where the crystals are at. I think their main mistake with this list is they play way too many Professor's Research. They don't need three. You probably don't even need two. You probably could just... You can get away with one research. You really don't need that many. They could probably cut research for more important stuff they need, like more energy, a crystal or two if they have it. I'm gonna take a look at their list after, maybe give it a little critiquey poo. What are they doing here? They're most likely just gonna do 300 damage. They can knock me out. Again, they can take the multiple prizes and then we just win with double. I don't see a way they can win the game in one turn. If we had another Snorlax VMAX in play, and it had any damage on it, there would be a chance we could lose to a double VMAX knockout if they had pings. Well, let's see what happens. Let's see what happens. They get rid of a switch. They must have just drew that after I knocked out their Crobat. That sucks. Well, even if they went a Zigzagoon, we knock it out, we just boss this up. Let's see what they got. Nope, they concede. All right, the superior Kanto VMAX has won the game. That's how you do it. All right, let's see what their list look like. I mean, they definitely need another Charizard V, I think. In terms of items, I think, yeah, they have way too many research. I think they can cut out a research. They definitely need to put a Fire Crystal or two in this deck. I think what this guy should do, oh, he had 11 energy. So he prized three fires that game. That's nuts. Yeah, I would take out a research and play a Fire Crystal. That's definitely what I would change about that list. Okay, guys, getting into the match here with our Snorlax VMAX deck here. So we'll see how this game goes. Try again. All right, we do win the coin flip. Do we want to go first or second, though? I think we're going to go second. Try to get that Volk start. Oh, we got a double start here. I mean, I guess this hand's okay. We have a quick ball, which kind of helps us out a little bit. Okay, so they're playing a fire deck too. It's a great time to play water. I've played against a lot of fire decks over the past week or so. So I'm about to just play a bunch of water decks to beat these fire decks. I don't think I ran into any fire decks when I was playing my Slowbro deck, which kind of sucks. All right, so they do Pokégear. We are going second, so they don't get to play any Welders or anything here, which is really good. If we can hit them with Revenge Blast, we could then finish them off with a possible Snorlax attack? Maybe? We'll have to do Quick Ball probably for Dedenne, unless, best case scenario, we draw a Welder here, or we draw into a Volcanion. No. Rip. Ugh, this hand's a little messy. Yeah, we're going to have to just Dedenne. We could go Crobat, I guess, too. But we're not drawing as many cards. I think we just did Dedenne. Unfortunately, I have to lose a bunch of energy, but we have Fire Crystal. There's Welder. We're one energy short, though. So we'll go here. Here. Get Snorlax. And hope for an energy here off Crobat. Alright, nice. We'll get rid of the other Snorlax, I guess. Alright, cool beans. This hand's not bad. If double cannot get knocked out next turn, that would be amazing. Because this hand, I think, really works if double doesn't get knocked out. So 120 damage. Actually, we knock him out next turn with powerful energy, so that's really good. So this Reshizard won't live the turn unless they heal. Alright, so yeah, I'm hoping double can live here. We do have 240 HP, so not even Flare Strike can KO me, which is really good. So, we should survive the turn, hopefully. If we can live here, this is nice. I want to be able to live the turn and then build up Snorlax and all that good stuff. Alright, there's a Welder. We'll see where they put it. Okay, they're building the active, which I don't think I agree with that, because this thing is going to get knocked out unless they play something silly. Okay, never mind. They're healing. Great Potion, the best card in the format, apparently. Alright, so now we're going to build up Snorlax, I guess. Honestly, I might retreat into Volcanion. We'll see. We will see. Okay, we can switch into Volk. That's even better. I guess what we can do, we can actually go into Snorlax here. And we can probably knock him out with Snorlax. We have 200 HP. We just need to get a Snorlax VMAX and an energy here. Okay, here's what we'll do. We'll Quick Ball for another... We could knock them out with Heatran. I just realized we actually can take a knockout with Heatran here. How many Fire Crystals do we have? We have two in the deck. I mean, I guess we take the Heatran KO. We could risk it and try to hit a Snorlax VMAX here. Oh, we already did Welder. Okay, no. Yeah, we do Heatran. We do Heatran. Yeah. No reason not to. Alright, this works too. Okay. Yeah, Hot Burn GX. Okay. Heatran's actually MVP in this entire video, which is kind of funny. Okay, we got another Volk. Let's see what else. Giant Hearth. Quick Ball. Alright, not really very good prizes, I guess, but we'll take what we can get. We probably should have gotten rid of the buff padding there instead of the calm, because we could have gotten a Snorlax VMAX. A lot of our luck right now is probably going to be relying on whether or not we find Fire Crystal, in all honesty. We'll see if they have any more Welders in their hand, though, to build up this Breaksard. Breaksard is a little scary. We don't have a way to one-shot it, so that could be a problem. It's a little bit on the bulkier side of what Snorlax VMAX can possibly knock out. Okay, they do Caitlyn Cynthia for Welder. And we did give him a free Giant Hearth. This is fine, though. We can actually just do Professor's Research. Give us a free turn to get a better hand. We're at this point, we're just trying to get like, oh, they concede. All right, well, Heatran is MVP-ness. All right, guys, get into another match with Snorlax. It looks like we've ran into a water deck here, so we probably, well, we are playing only like three fire Pokemon, so we should be okay. All right, we do get a Snorlax start. Not a bad hand. We got Welder, powerful energy, two energy. One thing missing is like a Crobat or a Snorlax VMAX. Let's see what we're playing against. Okay. Let's go put the powerful energy on the Snorlax. Don't think we're gonna get donked, obviously. I might bench Heatran here. Just to have it in play. I mean, I don't think there's anything wrong with benching Heatran just to fill up our bench too for Snorlax VMAX. Yeah, we'll bench it, sure. We'll just pass. We have Welder, so if they like bring it in with like a gust, I don't really care because we can just attack with it. So it's not a big deal if it gets brought in or not. Looks like they're most likely playing an Inteleon deck. Oh, they're playing Mewtwo. Water Mewtwo. Alright, well. We'll see how this goes. They are gonna get an early to dead A change. They are down, okay, they lose quite a bit of energy, which I mean isn't good. Now they got the Mewtwo. Will they be able to move the Dedenne and do Starstream is the question, though. Hopefully they can't do Starstream here. We'll see. Alright, they got a Research. Yikes. Okay, well, they lose a boss. Yeah, we're just kind of hoping they don't do Starstream. Oh, it looks like they got it. Oh, no, sorry. They got the Blastoise. They need a switching card here in order to get Dedenne out of the active spot. This might be a little difficult, though, to beat. Mewtwo does have a lot of HP. Alright, they don't have it? Nice. These top decks, though, aren't really doing me much favors. Hopefully we can get a Snorlax VMAX here off of our prizes. Good thing they get a Snom down, though, because they could knock Mio next turn if they had a Snom. Okay, Snorlax, double, we'll take it. We could do Falling Down to knock them out. I mean, we probably don't have a choice, to be honest. We kind of have to take the KO here, I think. Take our prizes now. Okay, there's a Dedenne. You love to see it. And there's a Scoop Up Net. All right, we don't need that. If we can draw a Zigzagoon, though, we can try to get damage on Mewtwo to set it up to be KO. All right. We are going to live the turn here, which is good. My opponent can't KO me with Mewtwo because they can't do enough damage with Blastoise. They can set up a knockout next turn, though, which is what I'm scared of. We could, I mean, hey, the option to Heatran again could be an option for us here, guys. I hate to break it to y'all, but we could go Heatran again and do a Hot Burn GX. We just need a switching card, and we could go for Hot Burn here as an option and knock out this Mewtwo in one hit. All right, five energy down. Ooh, they got a Counter Stadium. Training Court, okay, I'm actually down for that. That's actually not the worst stadium ever for us, because that gets us a free energy back. That helps us a little bit with Welder. Okay, well, they're setting up a little well here. It's good thing we had to get those two prizes, though, when we did. So, yeah, I think we might have to try to go for Hot Burn, assuming we can wake up and find a switch. Bomb of the Giant Heart isn't going to help our case, though, in getting the Hot Burn off. We'll see what we do. Hopefully, we can draw into a way to knock out Mewtwo here. If we can knock out the Mewtwo, I think we'll be in a good spot. Oh, we don't wake up? Oh, that's not good. Do a calm. Well, we can get Snorlax VMAX here, but we get knocked out by Rocket Splash. We just Welder. We'll see what Welder gets us. Let's Welder to this. There's a Giant Hearth. Okay, so we can put the Volk back for the Snorlax VMAX. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We need to get a switch. How many switch do we have? 2. Here's what we'll do. We can actually do a double Zigzagoon ping here. I mean, we still have to hit a switch. We could also just go Snorlax VMAX retreat if worse comes to worse. And we'll play this, take out a card I don't care for, like, probably we can get rid of a Snorlax, I guess. We can still do this. We can still attach. We have to attach. We're only going to get one energy, though. Put down a Heatran, Dedenne change, and hope for the best. Okay, nice. We got it. We got it. All right, beautiful. So let's go switch into Heatran. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 250 with the double Zigzagoon ping. Hot Burn for the KO. You love to see it. You love. Heatran is literally MVP-ing us. Every game I have used Hot Burn GX. This is insane. Yo, this man is bodying everything. Oh my gosh. And we actually do get some packs. That was a nice little KO, though, using the Zigzagoon Scoop Up Net combo. This is why I like having it in this deck. Just that extra damage boost. You already get a bit of extra damage. Why do I have 9 notifications? You already have an extra damage boost through powerful energy, but you might as well add on to that with Zigzagoon, and it kind of paid off there. So let's see what we get out of these packs. We'll do another match with the deck, though. These games have been kind of short. These last two games have been a little short. So let's see what we get out of this pack. That was a worthless pack. There's so many bad rares, man. It's not even that they have bad rares. A lot of the rares you pull, you can't use because ADP exists. That's one of the other things I think about ADP. Ooh, Hollow King is gone. Because with ADP being printed, they have all these really cool rares, like the new Blaziken, Gallade, you know, Kangaskhan, but they're never going to see play because ADP gatekeeps them out of the meta. That's another reason why ADP sucks, is because there's a bunch of Pokemon in every set that may seem cool, but they'll never ever work because ADP exists. That's another thing. That's just another reason to add on to it, is ADP prevents so many new cards from new sets from ever seeing play. So what's the point of printing new rares? You should just make sets just be nothing but VMAXs, because nothing else is going to stand a chance against ADP. There's another reason why ADP should be banned. Okay, guys, getting into another match with Snorlax here. Looks like we might have ran into a Pika ROM deck. This should be an interesting matchup, for sure. Well, yeah, we'll see how we do again. Alright, we lose the coin flip. They're gonna go first. Alright, that's perfect. Okay, well, we do just start with Snorlax and Goon. I think I'm still gonna start with Snorlax because if we're playing against Pika, Goon and Powerful Energy are what kind of lets us one-shot the Pika as long as we don't play Big Charm. So I'm actually gonna start with Snorlax and not Zigzagoon. We'll see how that goes. I mean, it could be a Pika deck. It might not be, you never know. Just because their deck box is Pika doesn't mean they're Pika, bro. That's so biased. Alright, we'll see what we do. This hand's not bad, though. I wish we had another energy to go with this Welder, though. That's the only thing. I wouldn't mind doing Swallow. We could knock out the Jirachi, actually. If we can draw into an energy here, a Fire Energy, we can knock them out with Swallow, which I would actually like to do. Okay, they do get a E-Radar. They get rid of a Stamp, though, which I like to see. They get a Pika and a Raichu. Okay, Raichu's a little scary. We actually only have two Switch in the deck. Raichu could be an issue. Pika, though, a lot easier to deal with. They didn't get rid of energy with that, which is good. Let's see if they play a Dedenne here. No, okay. All right, can we draw an energy and knock out this Jirachi? No, we draw a Scoop Up Net. Well. Okay, here's what we'll do. Well, Welder to the active. Only one energy. If we had a Switch here, we could have went Volt. That sucks. I mean, I can do Crobat, I guess, which I don't hate doing. I really want to knock out that Jirachi, though. Okay, well, let's just keep pinging this. So it's got 220 HP, which should be good. We'll leave it with that, and we'll see where this takes us. We'll Quick Ball away the research, I guess, for Crobat. Yeah, we're going to do Crobat here. I'm going to see what else we can get. I guess we'll hit the Raichu. Crobat. That actually leaves with 250 HP. We might have to use Heatran again. You never know. All right, we get a Giant Hearth. We'll play it. Thin out the deck a little bit more. We need to get Powerful Energy. Unless I want to put 10 more damage on that with Scoop Up Net. So we'll see what happens here. We might get Marnied, possibly. We'll see. Best case scenario, they don't attack me with Pika. There is a chance they do not. They still need Coco Prism, so there is a chance Pika doesn't hit me here, which is what I'm hoping for. If it does, we can still knock it out with Snorlax, but then we have to deal with Raichu. But we have Heatran, Hot Burn, because we put 10 damage on it, it has 250 HP. Well, again, Erica. Okay. Alright, here we go. Let's see if they can pull off a knockout here, or an attack, sorry, on my Snorlax. They could knock it out if they had a way to get 20 damage, but I don't think they can. I was about to say if they had an E-Power, but they don't. Okay, they get Erica again. Hey man, Erica's a good supporter. I ain't gonna knock you for that. Erica is a genuinely good supporter. When you have a good hand, you don't want to discard it. You might as well play an Erica, because it can draw you into more stuff to help you with that better hand. That's why I like Erica. Okay, let's see what they do here. I think I'm tempted to Welder to the Heatran. I think I'm going to, because we want to get a Powerful Energy on our Snorlax. Though we can always, you know, get another Goon and knock this out. We could draw a boss, too. No, do you have another Snorlax VMAX? Okay, let's attach. Okay, hold on. We'll Welder first to the Heatran. There we go. We got a Powerful Energy. Might hold the hand. I really want to do... I might do the Dede, though. I kind of want to do Dede change here to try to get... No, I don't know. Is it... Should we do Dede change? I don't want to lose my reset stamp, though, either. I kind of want to keep it. But, I mean, I think we'll be fine. Again, we have Heatran. Everything should be okay. Yeah, we're going to Dede change. Yeah. That's fine. I don't know if we really want to use... We're not going to use the reset stamp anytime soon, is what I'm trying to say. Okay, let's do this. We can either go Snorlax or double... I think we're gonna go double, because if he knocks out Snorlax, make him knock out Heatran next, and then we stamp, and then we have the double full ready to go. That seems fine. All right, we are doing the max damage we need. Now, my opponent can, I mean, we probably should have put 10 more damage on Raichu instead of putting the Dan damage here, but it's fine. We're still gonna knock this out. We should be chilling, and then all we have to do is knock out the Raichu to win the game. just gotta do hot burn GX and that will be that. Oh, they're gonna switch. They're gonna switch again. Wait, what? What's the point of that? I'm actually, what was the point of that? I guess like to do Erica, but I swear their hand was small enough. All right, whatever. Let's see what they do. We knock out Pika, we take prizes. Let's go. All right, yeah, just 150. You love to see it. So we'll see what happens here. They build Raichu. I mean, we could draw a boss. No, never mind. Just because we could draw a boss. Let's go here. Giant Hearth, Away of Calm. No Welder to the Heatran. Buff padding, I guess put that there. What am I doing? Definitely want to scoop up Ned Lagoon, ping it back down. Put 10 damage there. We're just gonna take a knockout. We are out of energy though, and I think we have one prize, so we should get one here. So I would like to Welder for switch, because all we have to do now is just do Heatran. We got a boss. Okay. See, all we have to do now is just do Heatran here, and we win the game. We can hot burn GX for 250 damage. Thanks those goon pings. That's what I like about Snorlax, though. Is Snorlax can very easily knock out Pikarom in one hit, thanks to the goon and the powerful energy combo. So. Well, they can't wait. They misplayed. What are they doing? Bro, what? All right. There you go. That's going to wrap the video on the Snorlax deck, I guess. They misplayed. I feel like they forgot to do Tandem Shock. I'll take it, though. A free win is a free win. And that is how you do it with Snorlax. I think I did a good job showing off how this deck played. We did get to use a lot of stuff with the Zigzagoon combo, which is pretty cool. I do like that we got to showcase quite a bit of Zigzagoon action in today's video. But other than that, yeah, this is the deck for you. The Giratina, you could take out. We didn't get to really use it, though it's still, like, a decent card. But if you take out Giratina, I feel like you have to play more Pokemon, because you want to make sure you have enough Pokemon in your deck for G-Max Fall. But other than that, yeah, this deck is really fun to play. Powerful energy, making Snorlax a little bit stronger. And overall, I think we did a good job showing off how this deck plays and how it works and all that good stuff. So thanks for watching today's PECGO video, guys. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like on the video, subscribe down below. If you're new to the channel, help me on the road to reaching 11,000 subscribers. And as always, guys, make sure to check out the sponsor card game TCG down below, guys. If you get any codes from there, use code LDF. Of course, the Eternatus VMAX and Eternatus V promo codes are over at Card Caverns. You can pick any of those up. Use code LDF. Check out my Twitter. I am running a giveaway over there, guys, for 10,000 subs. 5 different winners. All you have to do is like, retweet, and follow me on Twitter in order to be entered into the giveaway. And you can win some pretty cool stuff, including Secret Energy and ZCNV. So, yeah, thanks for watching. See you guys later. Bye-bye.